Yeah, y'all see it.
Yeah, yeah.
Hold up, y'all see it. Diamond so clear, can you see it? Ass so fat, I wanna see it. Hold up, y'all see it.
Am I really that much to handle? All I ask for you to keep it real. All I ask for you to keep it real.
Hey y'all, what's good? What it is? What's poppin'? It's your Terrible. And if you don't know, you know, so make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Turn on your push notifications, all that, okay? As you can see by the title, today's video is going to be a full makeup tutorial using all new products, especially my Fenty products, okay? So if you want to see how I got this look, because it's popping, okay? It's popping. If you want to see how I got this look, then just keep on watching. We're gonna jump right into it. As you can see by the title, today I will be trying some new products. The girl went to Sephora, okay? I'm excited, okay? I'm excited to put some makeup on this bare face. I haven't put my face in so long because I've been waiting to get some new products, you feel me? And now I got them. Alright, you guys. So as far as moisturization, I already moisturized with the Pond's Dry Skin Cream. And now we're going to go into primer. I'm so excited. As you can see by the title, you know, we're doing a full Fenty look. Okay, we're doing a full Fenty look. Alright, so I picked up her Soft Silk Primer. It's the pink one because this is the Pro Filter Hydration.
What the fuck is hydration, Injazer? Are you trying to say hydration or hydrating? Pick one, because that is not a word.
Primer, okay? And the girl just went to the dermatologist. It turns out I have dry skin. I don't know if it's because of the weather, but the girl got dry skin, okay? So I definitely wanted to get her hydrating primer. And this is the bottle. It's so cute. It's so cute. Look at the little cute packaging. It's so... I love cute packaging, and it's purple, bitch. Do you know your colors? And it's pink, like a soft pink. And like pink is my favorite color from Dean. Now, so yeah, we're gonna pop this baby open. I'm trying to smell it. Also want to see what the consistency about to be on. It don't really have a smell, but it's really like very lotiony. Basically like a lotion. Alright, hold on, before this gets on my nerves, I'm gonna go ahead and clip all this weave up. I ain't trying to mess up my curls, but they gotta get out the way right now, okay? So yeah, this feels just like lotion. A real loose lotion. It really does not have a smell. Like, it has a very faint smell, but the smell smells good. Made any sense, but off rip I could tell that it's making me look very dewy, and I like that. I don't like looking matte. I like looking dewy, and it's giving me that. It's giving me that dewiness that I like, baby. Giving it to me. Look, I look like I'm shining. Like, when you see the light though. Oh, I like this. It's not making my skin feel sticky or nothing. I don't like primers that do that, which is why I don't have a lot of primers. Begin with I'm skipping out on eyeshadow because I don't feel like it. Simple. I don't feel like it, but I like the way my skin feels regular. It just feels moisturized, so I like that. And it's giving me some glow. I'm fucking with it. Okay, so next I'm gonna go in with her the Pro Filter Instant Retouch Concealer, because y'all know what I do. Y'all know I like to put concealer on these little dark spots that I got. Okay, they're clearing up a lot, so that's good. But yeah, I'm gonna take this, and I am in the color. So now I picked up 370. Okay, so basically this is not my shade at all. When I highlight and conceal, I like to go up a shade so I can brighten as well as conceal. You feel me? I try to open it all nicely and I still ripped it. You know what? I'm sick and tired of myself. I'm too rough, I guess, but I like the shape of everything. It's like, it's slender, but it got a little curve to it. But this is what it looks like. The packaging is bomb. Y'all already have seen the packaging. I'm late, okay? I'm the one that's late, so if it seems like I'm doing too much with these products. I don't care, okay? Because this is my first time really using it. This smells like glue. And not like eyebrow. I mean, not eyebrow. Not like, not like lash glue, but like Elmer's glue. And I like the smell of glue. I don't know. I'm weird like that. But yeah, this kind of smells like the glue you used to use in elementary school. But it has like a thick consistency, and I'm effing with it because I don't like no runny concealer, okay? That's one thing that I don't like. This is good. I'm so excited. I just knew that everything was going to hit. Like, I just knew because Rihanna is a girl. She's a bitch. She's a queen, okay? And she ain't going to give us no foo-foo ass products. So I already knew it was going to slap. But it's slapping. Like, now that I'm actually messing with it, it's slapping. I'm also going to take my Sephora 202 brush, the small side, to blend this out. This is a foundation and concealer brush. So, yeah, I'm just going to do that. And it's blending into my skin, like, perfectly. And it has a lot of coverage. It covered that dark spot right up. Not even put a lot. When I tell y'all I'm about to look beat, I'm about to be beat, and I don't even got nowhere to go, like, but I'm going somewhere next week, so I'm trying to, like, test everything out. So I tested curling out my hair in a certain style, and I'm testing out these makeup products. And FYI, if you are into how my hair looks, well, y'all probably will see how my hair looks at the end of the video, because right now it still has to drop. But if you're curious as to see exactly how I achieve these curls in my hair, then, you know, just like this video, okay? And comment down below, because basically I'm going to be dyeing this hair, and then I'm going to curl it again on camera for you guys if that's something that y'all want to see. And this is the same hair from Jaja Beauty, that I had last time from that sponsored video. And I actually am taking the time to test the hair out, you know, put heat on it. I'm gonna dye it. I can't wait to dye it. And I'm gonna bleach it. Period. I can't wait. So basically, I'm doing all this to show you guys that I actually care about what type of brand sponsor me and like what type of products I'm vouching for. Because I'm not just gonna give no foo foo as for me. You feel me? Like, I'm actually gonna wear the hair and test it out for y'all, so y'all aren't wasting no money. Period, poo. And that's on menstrual. I'm never saying that again, dear mother. Alright, you guys, so I just finished putting on the concealer, almost said foundation, on my spot. And I'm noticing that it is starting to oxidize just a little bit, and I like that. Because that means it's just gonna blend a little bit better. But it's still very true to color. I do give it that, because it's still very much so lighter than my skin tone. But anyways, we're about to go into the foundation. And I got her hydrating foundation, okay? I didn't get the, the matte one, because y'all know I don't like matte. I'm dry and I don't like matte. But if you wanted to know, I am in the number or color 385. So I picked the 370 to conceal and 385 for my regular color. I like this packaging as well. This is so slender. Like, when I go travel, I don't have to get a huge bottle that's clunky and stuff, and I don't gotta worry about it breaking. That's one thing that I was always scared about with my NARS concealer. My NARS foundation. Not to compare the two, but you know, packaging is very important, and I love the fact that it's in this like squeeze bottle. It's so cute. It's like cute and dainty, and then it's still a pump, so I like that as well. We gotta let it pump out a little bit before any product comes out, because it's brand new. Come on now. There we go. That's a good amount for one pump, two. I'm gonna start off with three pumps, and let's see where that gets me, okay? Here we go! I'm so excited, okay? Y'all know I screech a lot when I'm excited. Oh, three pumps may have been a lot just here. 3 pumps. Has a smell to it too, but it doesn't, but it smells good. I don't know what I mean when I say that. It's like this, no, this definitely has a smell. This kind of smells like vanilla, and I love vanilla. Oh my god, this smells good. Okay, oh, this coverage is crazy. It's not drying, so I don't have to move like super fast. I can move at like a normal pace. Make sure I bring this down to my neck. The fact that it smells like vanilla and oatmeal. But I don't know. Don't take my word for it, because honestly, me and my nose, we're going through something. I wanted to get everything, so just to be clear, I only got the primer, the concealer, and the foundation from her. And then I got a setting spray from somewhere else, and I'm going to use that setting spray today. Even though it's not fancy, I'm going to show you guys anyways, because that's what I'm going to use. And I wanted to get so much more from her brand, but I didn't want to break my pocket. I'm going to tell y'all how much everything costs in just a second, but I wanted to get the setting powder. I really wanted to get the setting powder. I'm going to get my hands on the setting powder. Like, hello. And I didn't get it when everything first came out, but I had just restocked on my NARS, and I definitely was not going to get it online because I didn't know my shade. Like, when I went to Sephora, I had someone match me because I wasn't sure what color I was, because she has so many options. Like, that's amazing. But yeah, I just didn't know exactly which one to get. So yeah, that's why I didn't want to get it online, and I didn't want to go as soon as it came out, because everything was always like sold out. So, but y'all, when I tell y'all, I feel like this looks pretty fucking flawless. Whoa. Like, is it just me, or does it really look flawless? Okay, I'm supposed to be telling y'all how much everything costs. So, just if you don't know, or if you are new to Fenty, so the primer was $32, the foundation was $35, and the concealer was $26. That's an amazing price for this quality. Like, I'm really feeling this fucking foundation. Like, oh, and I also wanted to get her sponge. Speaking of sponges, let me go wet mine real quick, and I'll be back. Y'all, like, I'm not even sicing when I say this shit feels like skin. Like, and I'm so glowy. Like, my skin wasn't glowing like this before I put on makeup. Like, I don't know what's in that primer, but it's literally seeping through the concealer and through the foundation. Ah, this is just amazing. I knew it was going to be good, but why is it this good? Like, what's in here? Like, what? What's in this fucking product? And a little really goes a long way with her products. I'll probably have these products for a really long time, so if you see me using them in every video, don't come for me. Just don't come for me. But yeah, this is my sponge from CVS, I think. I don't know. I don't like this sponge, but I can't wait to get her sponge. I'm gonna blend this out, y'all. I'm gonna blend my Cupid's bow right now, but everything else I'm going to let dry. The only reason why I blend my Cupid's bow right away is because I got a little stash, you feel me, I really want to get my skin marker bladed, which is like shaving your whole face like with a facial. But yeah, I've got a little stashy, and the only reason why I'm scared to get dermaplaning is because I don't want it to grow back thicker. But yeah, I have to blend the concealer out on top of my lip because the hair right there, I don't want it to stick to it. And yeah, is that TMI? Oh well. But like, smooth before I put on powder. And my skin isn't smooth. Like you can see, I have texture. My acne has been a little haywire, but it smoothed it out. Of course, I'm gonna set it so we don't get no creasy creases throughout the day, throughout the night. I'm gonna use Airspun in honey beige. And I'm gonna try this new technique. I don't remember who I saw do this. I think it was Jackie, but like she so you know, people like put the powder in the top. Okay, I've been doing that, and they'll pick up a good amount. And I would blow mine off. Like, I would blow the excess away. But Jackie taps it on her hand. And if she don't do this, somebody did it. That I've been watching recently. She taps it on her hand. And I am going to try it for the first time. Only thing is, I can't do this and hold my my mirror at the same time. But that's okay. If this is going to give me a better finish, the powder on your hand with that body heat is like warming it up, and it's like going onto the skin a little bit smoother than normal. And now I'm going to take the Black Radiance True Complexion Contour Palette. I'm going to be mixing these two, and I am, that's a lot of product. But now I'm taking my Sephora 91 brush, and I'm just going to sweep away all of the Airspun powder. And if you were wondering why I left it on, I really don't like to bake, but I leave it on as a guide when I contour, because as you saw earlier, I'm not that best at contouring. I kind of just like thought about this. What if you were doing your makeup, you was in a rush, and you did the whole hand on the powder thing, powder on the hand thing, and then you forgot to take the powder off? Like, you will go out looking ashy as shit. Look at the difference. Oh no. Let me make sure I don't do that, because I don't need nobody coming for my life. Okay, you guys. So, I think the foundation of my face looks really, really good. Like, really, really good. I'm now going to take the Urban Decay Long Lasting Makeup Setting Spray, the All Nighter Spray. I haven't wanted to get my hands on this for so long, but I've just been lazy and cheap, and I haven't been trying to spend my money on it, because it was, let me tell you the price. This spray was $33. So yeah, this is what it looks like. It's so cute. I love gray and pink, but my favorite color also used to be purple, so I'm just living for all the packaging today. I don't know why it's two different tops. That's a little crazy, but you know, I ain't going off them, okay? I'm trying to see what it smells like. It smells like something, I don't know. Beat, like everything looks so nicely blended, and the only thing that's giving me gut is my eyebrows. I don't like my eyebrows today. My eyebrows are always a hit or miss. But anyways, I already had the Fenty highlight in me, Money and Hustler Baby. This is my favorite highlight. It used to be Laura Geller Gilded Honey, and I still love that one with a passion, but I lost it. Like, you don't gotta force it. I'm about to take this little mini size Travelers girl from Lancome is the Monsieur. I really hope that's how you say it. Or I just sound like a complete fool. Monsieur Big mascara from Lancome. Before I put on, woo, what the product looks like the packaging. I'm gonna put this on before I put on some falsies. Oh, I like that a lot, and I didn't put on much at all. I like that a lot. I'm gonna go ahead and put these lashes on off camera and come back, okay? Bow, bitch. Ah! Okay, so now that my lashes are on, it's time for the lippy. It's time for percolate. Let me go get my lip gloss. Okay, so I didn't notice that my camera stopped recording me, but basically I put the eyeliner from LA Girl in Deepest Brown on my lips to line them, and I like to go crazy with the liner. So I line them normally, and then I go on the sets and start blending towards the center of my lip. And I really did a lot today because I don't want this lipstick to be too pinky. I want it to be more of a nude. So I'm also going to just like block this. See, it's pink. Yep, that's all I need. That's all I need. Just for a little base, a little color. A little shum. I'm gonna top it with the NYX Butter Gloss and Fortune Cookie. Whoa, that's a lot. Usually I top everything with a clear lip gloss from NK, the NK lip gel, but I think this looks pretty good. It's not as like brown as I want it to be. It's still got a little pink to it, but I do really like it. I don't know. So now I'm gonna take my fingers and I'm gonna go through my hair, okay? I know I didn't even do my hair on camera, but this just goes to show that this hair really does hold a curl. Hello. Extra, so I'm gonna give myself a fake mold. I really just like doing this. I don't know why. I mean, I have a mold right here already, so I'm just gonna give myself that back because foundation always covers it. So this is the final look, you guys. I love the SHIT out of these products, okay? I don't know if it's the combination with the same spray, with the foundation, with the concealer, with that new method for the powder. I don't know what, but it's popping. Period. It's popping. That wraps up this video, you guys. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you for almost getting me to 14,000 subscribers, okay? If you subscribe to the girl, I F with you heavy, okay? And if you have yet to subscribe, I just want to know what you waiting on? What you waiting for, baby? You did it? Did you subscribe yet? Okay, so now that you did that, you can go ahead and follow my social media at lifeof_Jatera. Okay, that's my handle for like everything. But yeah, you guys, with all that being said, thank you so much once again for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial as much as I enjoyed creating it for you guys. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I will see you in the